Well, we have some challenging questions in our Bring It On session today. And Pat, this first one comes from Jenny, who says, I had a lesbian experience at a very early age. I love the Lord, but this experience still bothers me. And I'm now in my 50s. I don't understand why. Please help me to understand.
All right, I'll give it to you straight, Jenny. When you're young, men and females, they don't necessarily know what's there. And they have emotional needs, and they can fulfill those needs, especially physical needs, with members of the same sex as well as opposite sex. Just happens. Happens in prep school, happens in high school, happens in college. They don't quite know. So you had a lesbian experience. So you felt drawn, attractive to a woman, and you were intimate with her. And so you got over that, and you're into a heterosexual relationship, and you love the Lord. So, okay. You know, you were growing, and the Lord knows that. And so now you're mature, and you're not that way anymore. So why don't you bring it before the Lord and say He'll forgive you. If you want forgiveness, and I tell Him you did this, and you felt it was a sin, you're sorry, and ask for forgiveness. The Lord will forgive you. I mean, you don't have to worry anymore about it. I mean, what do you want to worry about? It's done. It's over. The Lord's forgiven you, and you're moving on into a wholesome, happy relationship. Don't let this thing in the past weigh you down. It shouldn't, okay?
Okay, this is Barbara, who says, why is it that only in the latest written gospel, John, does Jesus say that He's God? The earlier three gospels never record Him claiming divinity, only that He is a Messiah or anointed one of God. Surely the earlier gospel writers would have recorded such a tremendous claim if it were believed at that time. What do you think, Pat?
Well, you know, John is one book where the claim is made, you know, he is, you know, doubting Thomas, my Lord and my God. I don't know that the synoptic gospels, they were all apparently, it looks like Mark was the first, and he was giving an account of Jesus, but he was talking about the virgin birth. He was mm-hmm. talking about the fact that He was conceived by the Holy Spirit. He was, if you talk about the baptism, you're talking about the voice that comes, this is my beloved Son in whom I'm well pleased. You're talking about the devil trying to tempt Him in the wilderness. You've got all these things in there. How much more do you want? I mean, for frankly, all right?
Okay. This is Cynthia, who says, I have been hearing that in October we will no longer be using the dollar. Everything's going digital. If this is true, what's your advice for us to do?
My advice is to ignore that stuff. I mean, there's so much out there that scares you. And people, you know, they've got these newsletters and they want to write these scary things. And, you know, I've been working with the CIA, or I've worked with the Federal Reserve, and I'm an advisor to banks in New York and so forth. And here's what I say. No, this great country that we're looking at now, I mean, you're going to go digital in what day did they say, October?
October. I think we'd have heard about it.
This is the end of August right now, so you've got 1 month to change all the currency in America and go onto a digital format. It ain't going to happen, okay?
Okay, this is Carrie, who says, I can speak in 26 different languages. They're mostly from Asia and Europe. I am fluent in Japanese and almost fluent in Mandarin Chinese. My question is, what language or languages will we get to speak when we go to heaven?
I think, honey, you're going to be talking to the angels. I can't imagine anybody that's got the linguistic skills.
You've got
them all covered. Listen, I don't think we're going to be talking language. We're going to be talking thoughts. And the thoughts will be communicated without being verbalized. I don't think, you know, we need to even express it. But the mind will communicate the thought. I mean, we're going to be spiritual beings. And in heaven, we'll be, you know, in the presence of the ultimate Spirit. And all wisdom and all knowledge will be laid out before Him. And the minute we think something, it'll be done. I mean, it's going to be a whole different experience. So you don't have to worry about whether you're going to be using Korean or Japanese or...
You might want to work on your Hebrew, though,
right? Yeah. I don't think we're going to be working Hebrew either. I just don't think my language is going to... It won't count. I mean, it's going to be the language of the Spirit. We will communicate with our minds, and the minute we think a thought, it'll be there, so we won't have to verbalize it. All right.
Okay, this is Mila, who says, says, Pat, should I be out of the stock market during the upcoming Shemitah, September 13th, 2015? I have most of my life savings in the market, very conservatively, but I'm very worried as I'm a widow. If I should be out of the market, where should I put my money? Some of it's in an IRA and all the rest is in taxable accounts.
You know, I tell you what, I don't know. I used to think I had it cold. My performance when I was managing some serious money, I was up 20% or so a year. I had a tremendous track record. I knew exactly what was going on. I could spot the futures and get into it. But right now, it is so confused. Gold has taken a plunge. Silver has taken a plunge. Oil is in the tank. Natural gas is kind of floundering. The Fed has pushed the interest rates down on government securities so low that there is no income coming in for anybody on that. And I really can't tell you what to do, but I just believe that solid stocks that pay dividends and have a good, solid balance sheet that also, what Warren Buffett looks for is do they have an edge? Or is there something they're doing that's unique that will give them an edge in the market? And I think that's where you're looking for. But it's not a question of the market, it's a question of individual stocks.